Good morning, and welcome to the United Methodist Church of Sun City Center, Florida. I'm Keith Rasmussen, the Associate Director of Worship Arts and Organist at this church, and we welcome you to our concert this morning, concert of sacred music in our church with our Rogers Infinity pipe hybrid pipe organ. I would like to mention before we start some other upcoming concerts here at the United Methodist Church. On Sunday, September 20th at 3 o'clock, we will present Beethoven at 250. It's a tribute to Beethoven in this, the year of his 250th birthday. We will have seven local talented pianists, along with a talented local flautist, performing some timeless pieces by the master. You'll hear solos, four-hand and eight-hand works. We'll ask a $10 donation at the door. Next, Friday, September 25 at 7 o'clock p.m., we will host an Orlando area bluegrass band named Sandy Back Porch. They promise to bring a smile to your face with their hotter-than-fire, toe-tapping bluegrass standards played the way they're supposed to be played. We will ask a $10 donation at the door that night as well. We will be observing CDC-approved safety measures at these September concerts. That includes temperatures taken at the door, masks being worn, social distancing in our seating arrangement, and we will be observing the 25% capacity principle, meaning the first 175 people only will be admitted. So come early and don't forget your mask. We will advise of our October concerts beginning next week. If you have any questions about our contacts, please feel free to contact our concert series coordinator and my colleague, Kevin Goodnow, at 813-362-0956. I'd also like to mention that September 13, this coming Sunday, we will be opening our doors in a socially respectful way and having people here in the church again. It has been so long since we've had people here for worship. Looking out at empty pews just doesn't do much for us, but we know that you're out there. We hear from your emails and your phone calls that you're appreciating things, and we can't wait to see you again. Check the church website for more information. 8:30 is the first traditional service, 9:45 in the LEC over yonder, and then 11 o'clock after the sanctuary is cleaned, we'll have our second traditional service here as well. So come one, come all, just come with your mask, prepared to sit in appropriate ways, but we'll love to see you and be a part of worship with you again. Our first piece today is a German piece written by Bach. I'm not a German speaker, but this is close. Vater unser im Himmelreich, our Father who art in heaven. It's the German hymn or chorale based on the Lord's Prayer in German. This is played on this organ on the principles at unison and octave pitches, trying to make it sound as much like a Baroque organ of Bach's time as possible. For those of you who are understanding or who are about to learn, the 8-foot pitch on the organ is piano pitch. So if I play middle C on an 8-foot pitch, 8-foot stop, it sounds just like the piano would over here. A 4-foot stop is half the length and twice as high, an octave higher. So I'm using the mid-range 8-4, a little bit of 2 and light 32s to sound very much like a German organ. For those of you who are watching my feet, I understand there are some who do, you'll notice I'm playing with almost all toes. Well, there's a reason for that. In the German era of this Baroque style, the benches were high and the organist's legs were short. People have grown taller over the years, but they probably were 5 foot 5 with a high bench, so they could only reach the pedals with their toes. It gives a different effect, and you can play an awful lot with your toes. I use my heels a little bit for convenience, but mostly toes because I get a different sound that way. And for those of you who are specialists in early performance practice, you know that before Bach, musicians only used their middle three fingers to play the keyboard, and they dragged their other fingers along and behind. With Bach, he found it was better to play with all five fingers. So anyway, our first piece, Vater Unser, by Bach, from the German Baroque, Our Father Who Art in Heaven. Our second piece today is the aria by Flor Peters, who lived from 1903 to 1986. For those of you who understand organ history, he was a contemporary of Marcel Dupré, one of the greatest organists of all time. Peters studied with Lemons, who also trained the French school of organists, and I learned that style when I was in college. Peters was the organist at St. Brumbold's Cathedral in Belgium, I believe. He was a concert organist and lecturer and a researcher in early music. This aria is listed as one of his best pieces. I start the piece using European cathedral sounds, rather brittle, a little bit brash, and then as time goes on, I get more and more subtle and romantic. Going down to the strings and a nice clarinet at the end. The accompaniment is block parallel chords. It's a very interesting piece. I learned it in high school, but I play it much differently now than I did then. Anyway, the aria by Flor Peters. Thank you. Our third piece today is the Arioso, also by Bach, but in a much different style. This was arranged by Frank Asper, who was one of the organists at the Mormon Tabernacle instrument for many, many years. This uses the sumptuous orchestral sounds that this organ has. The middle section has a tiny oboe with a couple little mutations. This is the arrangement out of the same book that Virgil Fox used to play this piece. So the Arioso by Bach. Piece today is the Fantasia on Tony Botell by Richard Purvis. What is Tony Botell? Historically, people would put things in a bottle, cap it, and throw it into the ocean. Allegedly, historically, this tune was found in a bottle. And it's the Once to Every Man and Nation. I won't try to sing it for you, but most of you probably know it. This is written by Richard Purvis, one of my favorite organists and composers. And in looking at this in a new way before I got ready to perform it, it shows the struggle historically between good and evil. I haven't played it for church yet. I'm playing it Sunday because I need to explain it a little bit, which I'm doing for you folks now. This uses various forms to get the idea across. It starts with a fantasy, then it goes into a fugue, a march with a solo trumpet. There's a fair amount of dissonance, or the chords clashing a little bit, and then consonance, meaning the chords come together and they don't clash anymore. There's quite a bit of tension throughout, showing the struggle between good and evil, between choices that people can make and nations can make, and it's resolved in the final two chords. And then the pedal comes in with full pedal, just roaring, and seals it all off in a huge E-flat major chord. I'll tell you a little secret. When I was sitting in French class in the chapel right behind, or in the classroom right behind the chapel, my good friend Malcolm used to practice this piece, and I would hear it going over and over and over, and oh, I wished I was playing the organ, even in those days, instead of learning French. I think you'll enjoy this, but remember, it's a struggle, and at the climax, at the end, it's a very powerful work that I think you will enjoy, Fantasia by Richard Purvis. And thank you for tuning in today. God bless you today. Thank you.